Hi, I'm Peanut Louie Harper, and you're watching Asian American Sports with Rick Kwan.
She retired as a tennis pro in 1992, but you can still find Peanut Louie Harper on the court at least twice a week. Following in the footsteps of her four older siblings, the San Francisco native took up the game at the age of four.
Being the youngest of five in the family, I'm the baby of the family, so Peanut has just stuck with me since I was little. I love my nickname, yes. I love being called Peanut, and the only time I'm called Maureen is by someone, and I think, you know, I'm in trouble or something.
Encouraged by their mother, the Louie kids learned the game on the city's public courts. By the age of 16, Peanut had captured 14 national juniors titles. She gives a lot of the credit to her mom.
She just loved the game herself and just thought it was a great way to get the kids outdoors. And, you know, they were pretty serious about us getting a good education and everything. But, she just knew that, you know, to be good at something, and she, you know, saw that we had a little talent in tennis, that, you know, you really had to put in the time and the practice. And she just, you know, got us out to the courts every day and hit us a lot of balls. And that's how we spent our childhood.
After watching her oldest sister Marcy turn pro, Peanut did the same in 1978 at the age of 18. Playing against such names as Chris Evert, Martina Navratilova, and Virginia Wade, she would go on to have a successful 16-year career.
I mean, you seem so easygoing, but you say you're very competitive.
I would say it was my job. You know, I think it just developed as a kid when, you know, I played my first tournament when I was seven, and you know, I lost my first match, like, I think 0-1, and I don't remember liking that. I would probably say people would describe me on the court as pretty serious, or, you know, I just think I had a, you know, ability to concentrate, and, you know, just those hours of practice, it just, you know, trains you to just be so focused and be able to block out a lot of distractions.
As a pro, she won four singles and two doubles titles, and 16 singles matches in Grand Slam events. In 1985, Peanut was ranked 19th in the world after wins over Gabriella Sabatini and Zena Garrison.
You were maybe the only Chinese American or Asian American woman out there playing. Did you ever feel any discrimination at all?
I would say it was just a heat of the moment for her, this one player, and, you know, I beat her in a close singles match. She was an older player, and in the finals, and then I beat her in doubles, and when we shook hands, she just made not a nice comment, racial comment, and, you know, I was probably like 16 years old, and I had never experienced anything like that, and it took a while for it to sink in, like, what did she mean by that? And you know, she regretted it and wrote me an apology letter afterwards. And, you know, that was fine. But that was probably the only time I can remember ever someone saying a racial comment to me.
In 2003, Peanut helped put together a children's book based on the Pyramid of Success taught by legendary UCLA basketball coach John Wooden. She was introduced to Wooden by a mutual friend, Steve Jamison.
I just fell in love with Coach Wooden's philosophy, and just, you know, it felt like if my parents could write a book, these are the life lessons that they would be able to write. And I guess lucky me, you know, being at the right place and right time. And Steve asked if I would, you know, help with some ideas, and I said I would love to, and probably one of the best experiences in my whole life. And what motivated us to form our children's nonprofit, Harper for Kids, so we could do these tennis festivals based upon the children's book. And it's just been one of the most rewarding experience.
Her own teenage daughter is more into synchronized skating than tennis, but Peanut would like to one day see another Asian American girl find success as a pro.
Any advice I would want to share with young Asian American future tennis players is just put in the work and you know, keep a good head on your shoulders, keep it all in perspective, play the game for the right reasons, and just try and do your best, and the results will come.